Zoe Kravitz has made her engagement to actor Carl Glusman Instagram official.
How adorable. The two have been dating since 2016, and they are both from the Bronx, all the similarities. And you know, it's not official until you put it on social
Instagram.
Media,
That's right?
That's right,
because Zoe finally confirmed her engagement to Rolling Stone just a couple weeks ago.
Right.
But this is the first post with her man, with the ring, and it's
mm-hmm.
so cute because that Instagram post you guys just saw, she put a little heart emoji and the ring emoji. That's all you had to say.
I know. Should we get into like a little bit of who is Carl
Please.
Glusman? Okay, so you guys, he is an actor, and like I said, a lot of similarities. The two were both born in 1988. Like we said, he was born in the Bronx, New York.
Mm-hmm.
His acting credits include Netflix's Gypsy, Nocturnal Animals, and The Neon Demon.
Right.
And they've been dating since 2016.
And you'll remember in Rolling Stone, Zoe actually confirmed they had been engaged since February, but it's been keeping this locked up tight for a really long time,
you know,
up until now.
You know what's so cute? They did open up a little bit about the proposal. It was supposed to happen. He was supposed to surprise her in Paris, but, you know, some things don't pan out. He ended up popping the question in their living room.
Mm.
How romantic and intimate, just
you know,
the two of them.
That's how you know they're so private.
He lit, exactly, right? He lit candles and played Nina Simone music. How adorable.
She also even told, this is from the LA Times, she told them that she noticed how nervous he was and could hear and feel his heart pounding out of his chest, and noting that he was also a little drunk at the time.
Oh.
You know what? You need a little liquid courage.
You do.
You need a little liquid courage, or your whole life is about to change, right? You're about
100%.
To ask the love of your life to marry you.
Exactly.
You know?
Well, E.T.'s very own Kelsey Knight actually caught up with Zoe recently for her new project, Fantastic Beasts, Crimes of Grindelwald?
You
is that what
that,
it is? Okay. And we have a clip of that. Here it is.
It's amazing. It's so cool. There's so many different storylines in the
yes.
film that I was so excited to see what everyone else did and see how it all came together. It
yes.
is such a fun, beautiful film.
I know just our story.
She is, of course,
you know,
also working
together.
On Big Little Lies mm-hmm. season 2, which I'm really excited for. I believe they just finished wrapping the second season.
I believe it's in the can, and so I'm just like waiting like the rest of y'all.
I know.
For season 2 with Miss Meryl Streep. But, you know, also in this feature with the LA Times, you know, she talked about the fact that she has been working in the entertainment industry for a really, really long time. And then she, of course, has famous parents, Lenny Kravitz and Lisa Bonet. And she feels like she finally is forging her own path so much that she feels comfortable
to talk
talking about them, right?
Not having to, like, live in their shadow.
Exactly.
You know, like we said, like, Big Little Lies especially, she has made a mark for herself in this industry. And
there's the quote
know.
For us right there.
Yeah.
She says, for a very long time, I felt like I had to avoid talking about them because I wanted people to see me as an individual.
Well, we see you, girl.
I was going to say,
we
Zoe,
see you.
You're doing a really good job, girl. We see you. I mean, Rolling Stone, Elle, and LA Times, she is all over the place and really having her moment. Don't you think?
Yes. And in the LA Times, they actually asked her about, you know, did she have any feelings about filming a movie with Johnny Depp? And she says, of course, I'm stoked. I'm a fan because obviously there, you know, has been some backlash when he was cast in this film because of, you know, the accusations with Amber Heard.
Right.
And Zoe opened up and she says, you know, I don't think that's any of my business. And I also believe in second chances for certain people, depending on what we're talking about.
Yeah, she even compared it to working with Woody Allen. In fact, she says, I wouldn't work with Woody Allen, but I also don't think Woody Allen would want to have me in his films because he doesn't put people of color in his films, and they're all set in New York City, which is what makes her role in Crimes of Grindelwald so amazing.
Mm-hmm.
She said that J.K. Rowling actually said that this lead character, this huge character, should be played by a person of color,
right?
And Zoe got the part.